Hey, everybody. Hope you are doing well. We're going to check out another deeper track, and this one's by the band Mountain. And it's a deeper track in the sense of, you know, Mountain had a lot of great tunes, but let's face it, Mississippi Queen was their massive hit. Just is what it is. But part of the reason I'd say it's not 100% a deeper track is the sense is the fact that this song, Long Red, is one of the most sampled songs in hip-hop music history. Mountain has been sampled by hip-hop artists well over 170 times. That's more than Electric Light Orchestra, that's more than Pink Floyd, that's more than Led Zeppelin, that's more than the Beatles have been sampled by hip-hop artists. And so pretty close to the top of the mountain, no pun intended, when it comes to being taken apart and used as hip-hop fodder. So with that said, without further ado, let's check out Long Red, one of the most sampled songs in hip-hop history by the band Mountain. Leslie West's voice is amazing. And with all the really good Mountain songs out there, you probably wouldn't have expected hip-hop artists to be sampling one that's primarily an acoustic tune. Obviously, Leslie's guitar playing at the end, the solo at the end's got some nice little riffage in there, but you probably wouldn't have expected that to be the one of the, you know, the kings of the sampled hip hop world, but it is. And again, you know, I don't have anything against, you know, artists' music being sampled as long as they're being properly compensated for it, mind you. Because as I said in other videos, you know, it's always interesting to see where creative influence comes from. And if there are hip hop artists and pop artists out there who are taking tribute or taking inspiration from artists like Mountain and the Beatles and Billy Squire and Hall & Oates and other artists, again, as long as the original artist is being fairly compensated and not fully ripped off, I think it's really a unique way of creating. I mean, in the grand scheme of things, let's think about this. You know, music itself is an evolution. It just is. You know, whether you go back to, you know, the pre-Baroque periods of classical music and how, you know, one classical composer inspired another classical composer inspired another classical composer, which then melted its way into classical guitar playing and other classical symphonies, which then influenced blues artists the blues artists influenced jazz and rock artists, and the big band artists took note from, you know, chamber music and what have you. I mean, it's everybody is taking from everybody. So to sit here and, you know, have some people out there raise hell over the fact that somebody got sampled and they're taking my music, so on and so forth. Well, who did you rip off to get your sound? Who inspired you? What is the amalgamation of influences that created your style and your tone? You know, I'm never going to sit here and say that I'm an original guitar player or an original musician, because I was inspired by, you know, Hendrix and Cream and Frank Zappa and Van Halen and King's X and Government Mule in Chicago and, you know, Muddy Waters and the Blues Brothers and, you know, going all the way Paganini and Bach and you know, Count Basie and Buddy Holly. And I mean, Ray Charles, my first musical influence, Buddy Rich, one of my other first musical influences. I mean, I am, and as are all musicians, again, an amalgamation of the influences that inspired us to learn how to play and the songs that we figured out when we were growing up and how we incorporated the tricks and the trades and the musical ideas from artists that inspired us to even pick up the instruments or sing a song in the first place are parts of our genealogy when it comes to how we create and what inspires us. So realistically, people got to get off their damn high horse and stop worrying about, well, this is a ripoff of that, you know? I mean, sure, when Ray Parker Jr. ripped off Huey Lewis in the News to do this theme to Ghostbusters by ripping off I Want a New Drug, that was a little bit direct. You know, when Tone Loc took the riff from Van Halen's, you know, Jamie's Crying to create, you know, Wild Thing, you know, again, it's a little bit direct, you know, but again, as long as people are fairly compensated, it is what it is. Because again, you can go back and rediscover these things. If you're a hip hop fan and you go, oh my God, they took samples from this band Mountain, maybe I should go back and listen to that band Mountain and see what's going on there. Maybe there's something I can get inspired by. Again, it's just opening the horizons of the musical world to artists who may not have been, you know, educated on it or even aware of it in the first place. Again, kind of the beauty of all these reaction channels that are out there that we all sat back and watched for a couple of years, and we're sitting here watching these people go, oh my God, I've never heard this song before. And you're like, how on earth did you not hear Turn the Page by Bob Seger? Or how on earth did you not hear Texas Flood? Or how on earth did you not hear, you know, Van Halen play Eruption? And we're sitting here going, I hadn't, on the other side of things, we're like, I had no idea that hip hop artists were sampling Mountain and Hall & Oates and Billy Squire and ELO, you know, but they were. And so, you know, just take the blinders off and get out of your comfort zone and listen to other music, and you'll be shocked at how much stuff overlaps. Off on another tangent again. Sorry about that. Please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. Know that I appreciate you and thank you all for watching the video. And I wish you all well, okay? Y'all take care.